example of what I was talking about. This is just the hardest thing. So I've intervened for the third time to help this baby bird get out of that shell. And you can kind of see there's some blood right there. So this is way more than I was comfortable doing, but at least I know her head's out. She can breathe. But she's gonna have to do what she has to do to figure out how to get out of the rest of the show. That's it, baby. Keep fighting. I want to help you, but I'm afraid if I pull the rest of that shell off, I might pull something off. Keep fighting, baby.
Alright. I guess I can laugh now. I stepped out of the front door at home, and I heard voices. It sounded like voices in my barn. So I strapped on a 45, came out here, and I guess I'm on the far corner of the property, and over that hill, it sounds like somebody's having a big, I guess, Father's Day. You can hear him. Big Father's Day party, I'm guessing. Sounds like they're speaking Spanish. It's just funny.
Weird.
All right, guys, false alarm. Let's go. Good morning, everybody. Today is Wednesday, the 19th of June, 2019. What we got going on here? Yesterday, I transferred, the 15 odd ducks over there that were in the brooder room. And I ended up putting them in a unused barn stall that historically was a chicken coop. But I figured give them a chance to kind of spread their wings a little bit. Anyway, so these guys have been in here for about a day or two. And then the three that were born late, I'm moving them in here from the brooder in the house. So it's time to release these guys. Come on, guys. Go get them. There you go. There you go. Oh, look at all the ducks. Ducky doos, you guys better be nice to them, even they're a little smaller. Oh, look! They assimilated right in there. I see at least, see that black head right there? There's at least one being critical. Alright, you guys be nice, let them in. Keep them warm. You tell them. Good job. Well, you can't say I didn't try. So I was able to coerce Miss Bianca here. Relax, baby. We're freaking out. I coaxed her reluctantly into the coop here with the babies. And if you look closely, over half of those ducklings, the ones that are lighter in color, are hers. There's two females that were dropping eggs that I was collecting. I would have thought I would have had more dark ducks because the other girl was black and the drake is black. So I just would have thought statistically there would have been more black ducks. But looks like at least half of them are hers. You're a horny little thing, aren't you? Anyway, put them in here together, watched them for about 20 minutes. I don't know why she's acting so kind of stoic right now. Probably because I got a camera pointing at her. She was not as receiving. It was like an experiment. I was kind of hoping she'd show some maternal instinct because she's really, really been trying to hatch eggs over the last year and a half or 2 years. She's laid so many eggs, nested them. One time she sat on a bunch of eggs for pretty much the whole hatching period, like a month. And right in the very end, something happened, and I think a predator, coyote or something, got the entire nest of eggs in one night. So, but she's just been trying and trying and trying to hatch her own eggs. So I was kind of hoping that maternal instinct would lead her to warm up to these guys a little bit, and she really didn't. Man, she wasn't overly hostile, but wasn't nice either. You know, she kind of darted at them. There's a, if you know duck behaviors, I call it the shovel nose. They drop their head down, and they make this like a shovel nose motion that, you know, it's their way of saying back off or I'm pissed off or whatever. So she did that. She kind of charged at him a few times, like kind of like a bowling ball into bowling pins. Didn't bite anybody, you know, so that's good. But not what I was kind of looking for, so I'm going to go ahead and let her go. Because I just went in and did some homework, and apparently I wouldn't think a duck could kill anything, but they will kill ducklings that are, you know, foreign. So I don't want these guys getting hurt, so... They're staying. You, young lady, you're going back out in the pond. Quack, quack. Well, you're just a stoic little bitch tonight. Whatever. There you go. Thanks for participating in my experiment. Keep going. You're free. Sorry for the inconvenience.
Hello there, mister. Is that you I heard croaking? Good night.
Good morning, everybody. Today is Thursday, the 20th of June, 2019. Had to laugh. I thought I'd share this with you guys. I'm sitting here working. It's like, this is fine country living right here. So this is kind of my fermentation corner. But I'm sitting here drinking my green smoothie for breakfast. Had to recover some baby duckling food from something. And as I was making my smoothie, I noticed over in my fermentation bin over there that I've only been doing water kefir for a couple weeks now. Actually, 2 weeks. So if you're familiar with water kefir, or kefir, some people call it, it's basically another fermented drink, fluid. So I've been making milk kefir for a couple months now. In the last couple weeks, I transitioned. I'm still making milk kefir, but now I'm making water kefir as well. Anyway, I found a guy online who swore by adding a fig to his water kefir, which kind of gets the microorganisms really excited. And they do, you know, basically the beneficial bacteria in the yeast go bananas and consume the fig. So there's a Turkish fig right there. But when I looked over there, I was like, uh-oh. What the hell is that on the surface? Oh no, something went wrong. Anyway, I'm doing my homework, and this is why I was laughing. So again, this is just fine country living right here. I don't think it's mold, but I still have some homework to do. To me, yeah, see, those look like air bubbles. There's still a film on the top, which is said to probably be overactive yeast. And that's not bad, because this whole concoction is all beneficial bacteria, aka probiotics, and yeast, which are good for your gut. But the reason I was laughing is I had to go down and get my gunsmithing goggles headset so I could really take a microscopic, it's almost like looking under a microscope and look at some of this stuff. But as far as I can tell, now needless to say, I am not eating that fig. Even though the figs, before I sampled them, before I threw this fig in here, oh, amazing Turkish figs that I got from Amazon. So that's going to be a regular purchase going forward, just for general consumption. Anyway, there's my water kefir with some kind of a surface contamination, maybe. But at the end of the day, I will know. Either I'm going to dump this and recover it and fix it, or it'll prove to be beneficial yeast. I'll just drink the damn thing. So if I'm dead in a week... You know why. Dude, what are you doing? Really, you gonna lay in a puddle? It's not even hot yet. Well, sorry folks, I guess I won't be filming anything with the GoPro camera for a while. Usually I keep it outside on the bump helmet, keep it at ambient temperature so it doesn't fog up so I can use it real quick. And I just looked inside the helmet and there's a damn bird nest. Sorry, baby. Didn't mean to scare you. You got any eggs yet? Dare I look?
There's an egg. Sweet. All right, we'll leave her alone. Anyway, no GoPro for a while. Damn it.
Look, it stopped raining.
Yay.
I'm kind of driving a little bit aggressively, trying to get our asses home, me and them. Because we were just at the store getting some stuff, because little Deuce said he wanted hamburgers off the grill for dinner. I was like, we don't have the stuff for hamburgers. He goes, the store is only like 5 miles away. So whatever. So we went to the store and got stuff to make Deuce burgers. And at the store there, we saw about five of those big-ass utility service trucks that you normally see around hurricanes and tornadoes and stuff. And it's just weird. And then the weather has been, for the last 15 minutes or so, we're seeing some really weird wind gusts that are knocking trees down, or not trees down, knocking limbs off trees and whatnot. And you're not gonna be able to see it right now because I'm right in kind of a green alley, but over there, a pretty nasty thunderstorm, and my weather app on my phone is squawking saying there's a major thunderstorm heading in. So we're driving like a banshee trying to get our asses home to get the food in the house. Get the dogs fed their stupid burgers. Yeah, good way to wind up the day. Love it. Fine country living. Doop, doop, doop. Over, duper. You loving life, baby? You loving life? Gonna eat a burger too, fat bitch? All right.
Hey, Oop. There's your buddies. Oopie, there's your buddies. There they go. Oi, get the monkey. Outside, outside, monkey. Other way. Outside. There. You don't see him? Yeah, about damn time. You want a burger, you gotta earn it, fat bitch. There you go. You tell him. Tell him. Good girl. Alright. Good girl, baby. Stupid stinky deer in our field. It's unacceptable. Man, we just got home right when that damn storm hit. You can hear the generator in the background. Our power's already out. Weird. It's just a weird storm. I don't know why. It's just weird. It's the only word I can think of. The fact that the power's out already, I mean, compared to other storms we've suffered, this ain't shit. I just don't get it. Whatever. At least we got hamburgers. Whoop, whoop. I probably shouldn't think this is funny or cute. This is going to cause problems in the future.
Well, that was probably one of the more prophetic things I've ever said or felt. You know, it's almost like my intuition knew what was coming. Don't you wish you could stop time and rewind it and do things different?
Let go! Let go! Asshole!
This just breaks my heart. Total accident, you know, just rough housing. But if you look in this freeze frame and look around his nose and see all the white fragments there, unfortunately, that's two of Deuce's teeth, in particular, one his upper right canine incisor tooth. Sadly, even though, you know, we were just kind of playing with that tire, he sunk his teeth into the tire, and right when I kicked it, trying to kick it away from him, I watched it in slow motion enough times to know that I think when I kicked it, the steel rim on the tire was pushed into his tooth line, and cut to the chase, he lost two teeth, unfortunately, his incisor and one of his premolars. So poor Dudu had to go to the vet for emergency surgery shortly after this and have those two teeth removed, and we'll cover more in a minute.
Uh-oh.
Shit. I'm sorry, Bubba. You okay? Shit, he broke his tooth. God damn it. You know, in hindsight, that was such a freak accident. And Deuce had his teeth sunk into this rubber when I kicked the tire. And he unfortunately lost two or three teeth. And that's actually pieces of his tooth right there. And it just breaks my heart that he got hurt like that. It's so weird though. Never would have thought that would have happened, obviously.
Poor doo-doo. We just got him home and he's still stoned out of his mind. He's like trying to walk a drunk sailor home. Boo-boo.
What's the matter, Deuce?
I know. Can you make a pee-pee poo-poo and we'll go upstairs and go night-night? Hey, Deuce.
It's me, Bubba. It's me.
Come on, Bubba. Pee-pee poo-poo. Can you walk? Come on. Come on, you heroin addict. Come on, babies. Come on. Let's go. There you go. A little wobbly, but that's okay. Come on, Bubba.
That's a good boy, the Deuce. There's a little tail wag. You still got it in ya? Good boy. I love you. I'm so sorry, baby. I'm so sorry. Oh, man. Dad's my boy. It's good to have you home. Good boy. You're gonna get babied for 2 weeks. Don't get used to it.
Doo-doo, give me the chewy. You're not supposed to be chewing nothing. Okay, come here. You come here. What'd the doctor tell you? No chewing for 10 days. Come here. Give it. Deuce. Come here. Come on. Let's go. Good boy. Come here, wiggle butt. Good boy.
There you go, boy. I gotta take your toy, Bubba. You can't chew.
Come here. Give it. Deuce. What'd I say? Come here. Deuce. Give me the toy. Now. Give it. You bad boy. You're gonna bleed all the house. Ding, ding. Good boy. Come on. Drop it. Good boy. Please. There you go. Come here. Give it. Oh, close enough.
Good afternoon, everybody. Today's Saturday, the 22nd of June, 2019. As you will have seen in an earlier video, so Deuce got injured yesterday. He's medicated on pain meds. He's not really chilled out, but anyway, it gave me an opportunity to kind of sequester him for a little bit. And I decided to get out here and plow up the garden pasture as it gets ready to rain. So I'm trying to hurry up and get it done. But I noticed something interesting. I think I've commented and maybe even covered this before. You can kind of see it here, but I'm gonna jump back on the tractor and do it kind of like a panoramic thing, and I'll shut up and then I'll do a voiceover. But look at the different colors that exist in this soil. There's at least four. There's like a sandy right there. It's like a sandy, whatever sand, I'll call it sandy. There's a red clay. There's kind of like the dark over there by the tractor. And then up there, you know, it's kind of like sandy, loamy, clay, and then whatever that you want to call that dark stuff, which is actually composty, we'll call it. So it's like four different primary colors in here. It's like a Neapolitan ice cream. And no matter how often and how much I plow it and till it, it just seems to always stay discrete colors. It doesn't mix in, which drives me bananas. It's not, you know, I'm sure a soil scientist would say it's not a big deal. But it just won't mix in. It drives me bananas. Anyway, I'll jump back on the tractor and I'll do a single lane pass. I'll probably back up, reverse, and show you guys what I'm talking about up close. Of course, the donkeys are going, they always get excited when I'm doing this kind of thing. I actually just hit
Soleil, the big one, I just hit her in the butt with the front loader. She was sitting in front of the tractor, wouldn't move. So I kind of clipped her in the behind with the front loader, and ooh, she was mad. She was barking at me. I'm like, whatever. It's your fault. This, I think this is funny too. I don't have to feed them hay anymore because they found the two hay bales here and just kind of helped himself. Hey girls, what's she doing? They're just kind of eating the center out of it. It's like, whatever, that's what it's there for. Here's another thing I thought was funny. Saw this when I was on the tractor earlier. I didn't put that there. Some, one of those dumbass chickens in it. I can, it's actually, yeah, it's back. I was gonna say, because I've got this fencing in here now, so the chickens can't get in here, so I don't think I've had a chicken in this pasture for at least a week or 10 days. So that egg's been there for a while, I just haven't seen it. All right, back on the tractor.
All right, so here you can see the different colors. There's kind of like the sandy and then the dark. And we're gonna transition, there's the clay red. There's the real dark, heavy again. More sandy, more red. Just like cosmopolitan ice cream. I don't know what else to call this stuff. Maybe one of these days it'll all be one color. It might take me 20 years, but we'll get there eventually.
Amazing.
You guys were just looking for the food, not the babies. That's not right. Those are your babies. Sure, I hatched them, but they're still your babies. Good morning, everybody. Today's Sunday, the 23rd of June, 2019. Just rolled out of bed, haven't even had coffee yet, and we're already getting ready, getting started. I got four sourdough loaves that I rise overnight. Now I gotta prep them and get them in the oven. Two whites and two wheats. We'll see how these bad boys come out today. Coffee first.